Hello everyone, in this video we have one quad circle. Point O is given, center of this quad circle, and this length is given 5, here is given 3, this length is given 4 root 2, and these are given 90 degrees. So the question is, what is the radius of the quad circle? Okay, first step. If we draw a perpendicular line from center onto the chord will be divided into two equal parts. So these two parts must be equal to root 2. Right? Okay. After that, if we draw one more perpendicular line like this, let's call here point K. If you notice that, we get a rectangle, right? So CDEK is a rectangle. Therefore, if it is 3 units, this length is also 3 units. So 2 units left here, right? Next step, let's call here point T. Notice that point T is midpoint. So if you focus on here, here is 90 degrees, and these two parts are equal to root 2. Right? After that, if you draw one more perpendicular line like this, let's call here point P. This length is 2 units. And here, this length is also 2 root 2. After that, let's call here alpha, here theta. We know that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees. So here must be equal alpha, and this angle must be equal theta. Notice that this triangle and this triangle have same angles. That means these two triangles are similar. So triangle OPB and triangle CTO are similar. Then, I want to represent this length with x. Therefore, if we start with this triangle in our calculations, x, which is opposite of the alpha, over 2 root 2, which is opposite of the alpha, must be equal 2 root 2, which is opposite of the theta, over x plus 2, which is opposite of the theta. Therefore, after the cross multiplication, x squared plus 2x equal 8. X squared plus 2x minus 8 equals 0. Therefore, x squared equals x times x, and minus 8 equals 4 times negative 2. That means x plus 4 times x minus 2 equals 0. Therefore, x equals minus 4, but it cancels that, so x is going to be 2 units. Let's write here x equals 2. After that, if we connect point O and point E like this, if you notice that, this length is radius. Next step, this length is also 3 units, right? After that, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of R. So 2 root 2 whole squared plus 7 squared, this length, equal r squared. Therefore, 8 plus 49 equal r squared. That means r squared equals 57. So r is going to be root 57. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of radius using second method. Let's draw one perpendicular line again. So these two parts must be equal to root 2. And if we connect point B and point C like this, this length, let's call here A. Notice that this is a trapezium, right? So CDEB is a trapezium. Therefore, A must be equal 5 plus 3 over 2. Therefore, A is going to be 4 units. Next step, let's call here point M. At the same time, point M is a midpoint, right? We know that here is 90 degrees. That means this length is equal to the others. After that, let's draw one more perpendicular line like this. If it is 3 units, this length is also 3 units and 2 units left here. Moreover, this length is also 4 root 2. Right? Let's call here y. So these are also y units. And for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of y. So 2 squared plus 4 root 2 whole squared equal 2y whole squared, right? Therefore, 4 plus 32 equals 4y squared. That means 36 equal 4y squared. So y squared equals 9. Y is going to be 3 units. Just right here, y equals 3. Next step, if we connect these two points, this length is also radius, right? Therefore, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of radius. So 7 squared plus 2 root 2 whole squared equals r squared. So 57 equals r squared. That means r equal root 57 units. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.